Welcome to Ocrop's YouTube channel, your world for information. Topic is the unknown Chanakya, Anartha Sastra, and the social engineering. Thanks to all those who have subscribed to my channel and watching my videos. Quick request to all those who haven't, please check out my videos, and if you like, share and subscribe, comment. India has been a land of hero worship, and there have been many heroes without historical evidences, but still, for whatever reason, they are portrayed as great, as legends. Such mysterious historical character is Chanakya. Chanakya, the same man as Kaudilya, who helped the Chandragupta Maurya to build the Mauryan Empire, destroying Dhanananda? We don't know. There are no evidences to say that Chanakya was Kaudilya. And there was no evidences to say Chanakya is or was the Vishnugupta, Greek traveler Megasthenes, who wrote a lot about the Mauryan Empire and its features in his book Indica, never mentioned anything about Chanakya. So historically, the facts are not corroborative, and there are lot of things left to assumptions. Indian literature is one of the most corrupt and fudged to uncover a lot of facts. A lot have been swept under the carpet. And unfortunately, these characters, historical characters who have been worshipped, are quoted, and they have been portrayed as great heroes. For example, the Chanakya Nidhi is called the Bible of Indian politics. Now you know why in the Indian politics is so cheap. Let's assume if Chanakya was part of the great Chandragupta Maurya Empire, and he has built everything, and he has done a lot of things, and he has written the Chanakya Niti, the book which helps all the kings to govern their country. If this was the reason, why did Chandragupta Maurya become a Jain monk? I will leave this to you. You know, please comment. Let's try to unearth Arthashastra, what is called as Arthashastra or Chanakya Nidhi. It has got 17 chapters, which are applicable to the modern day world, some of which are not applicable. But it certainly gives an idea of the age in which it was written. Chapter 1 talks about who will suffer. 1. Who guides a brainless idiot will suffer. One who has a wife who is not kind will suffer. One who moves with people who are not good will suffer. Live with a terrible husband, the bad friend, and a useless helper. It is equivalent to living in a home where snake is living. Number one says, money is a necessity of everyone, and one has to save money. In the saved money, he should save his wife, and also he should perform all the rituals to please the higher society and God. One shall even sacrifice wife and all his wealth for the sake of Atma or the Self. One also talks about the immigration, where you should not immigrate. Where there is no respect, where you cannot mint money, where you cannot have good friends, or where you cannot enhance your knowledge, do not immigrate to those countries, is the message in chapter 1. Your domicile should have a rich man, a Brahmin who knows the Vedas, a king, a river, and a doctor. If these five are not there, do not go and stay in that place. Also, in the chapter 1, advises not to be proud of money, and money can destroy anytime. It will vanish and it can destroy you. So says where intelligent people won't go, people won't even step. One is where poverty is there, where crime is happening, and where people with generous mind are not there, and people are idiots, or people without social responsibility. If these people are there, then no learned man or no intelligent person will enter that place. Also talks about the intimacies of relationship and whom to believe, how to believe, what are the criteria for believing someone. All these are discussed. It also talks about the art of sacrificing. If someone is sacrificing something for a person with unstable mind, then they lose both. Intelligent man will only marry a girl from a good family, even if she is handicapped. Beautiful, if she is not from a good family, an intelligent man will not marry her. It is advisable to marry a girl with similar financial status. Whom should we fear according to the chapter 1 of Chanakya Niti? It is the fast running river, man with weapons, animals, a woman with lot of proud on her wealth. If you see all these people, you'll have to stay away, stay aloof. And the best part of social engineering comes here. Who is intelligent? Take one who can take medicine from poison and make wealth from a ditch. Who is smart enough to understand the nature of a woman, good woman, even though she is born in a lower caste? How? The most interesting part, it's about the women. Women have more sense of feeling for food, at least twice the feeling of that of men for food, and they have four times the feeling of shy as that of men, and they have about six times of guts than men, and they have about eight times of feeling for senses. I know you would understand what this means. I still could not understand the reason why these types of books are portrayed as great books, and people, I don't know, the caste system has to, if it has to live, these books have to survive. Another sort of character called Manu, whose Manu Dharma or Manu Sastra is the basis for the caste segregation in this country, is also portrayed as a great thing, but nobody knows who this Manu was and where he lived and what he did and when this book was written. No historical evidences. All these are supposed to be facts if the historical evidences are not proved. But I don't know, even the greatest of people, they take these things as references, as examples for future things. I don't know. I see a lot of people quoting Chanakya Niti, and I was interested in understanding what was in this, but it turned out to be a experience that forgettable experience. It is just the beginning. If you like this, please share this, and if it is welcoming, then I will continue with more from this Chanakya Sanartha Sastra and the social engineering part. Okay, thank you. Bye bye. Thank you.